over the natural course of the evolution of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, many different genetic variants of the virus have emerged. Some of those variants have become variants of concern because they may be changing the nature of the disease. The three that we're hearing a lot about are one that was associated with the UK, one with South Africa, and one with Brazil. They all have small mutations to the structure of the virus, some shared, but also some differences that may be changing the nature of the disease. Variants to the virus arise naturally simply because so many people are now being infected by COVID-19. Each new infection creates a new opportunity for slight changes in the virus. So that's how they arise. However, some of those variants could be preferentially selected as they're encountering the human immune system. For example, if there are antibodies that are formed to an older version of the virus, you know, perhaps most of the versions of the virus are eliminated by those antibodies, but a few get through. And then those go on to proliferate and become a full-blown case of COVID-19, which then spreads. And if some of those variants are more effective at spreading the disease, then they start to dominate and take over. There's definitely a kind of irony here where the more we're trying to contain the virus, the more we're presenting it with obstacles that it may be able to overcome and come up with sort of more resilient versions of itself. So we are, in effect, in a kind of arms race. This is taking place or playing out on a few fronts. If the virus becomes more transmissible, it's a concern for public health measures. It means we have to tighten up on preventing the virus moving from one person to the next. If it's also increasing the number of cases, then that's going to strain the healthcare system, hospitals as well. And finally, if the variants are different enough, they may begin to impair the effectiveness of vaccines, not just how well they can cope with the variants right now, but potentially how long our immunity can endure once we've had our full dose. Those are all reasons for concern, and that's why you're seeing so much activity now turning towards these new versions of the coronavirus. Canada has every reason to be concerned about these variants, and genomic surveillance is underway. So some fraction of all COVID cases, the viral samples from those cases are being sequenced so that their genomes can be read and compared to known variants of the disease. So Canada's looking at the possibility of those variants coming in through travel cases, but also the possibility of other variants arising within Canada, particularly as the vaccine rollout proceeds. So there's already been a big uptick in the number of sequences that have been conducted, and I think we're going to see more of that because in a way, that kind of genetic surveillance is really our only tool to keep on top of these variants and see what the virus is doing.